Hey, welcome back to TekShinji. In this video, we're going to go over the parts breakdown of this rig and go over some little nuances and what I found in my experience building it and just why did you water cool it? Part we're gonna go over is the CPU. I get so many questions about the CPU. Is a Core i3 enough? Shouldn't you use a Core i7? Shouldn't you use a Core i9? When it comes to mining, you really don't need like any CPU, like at all. You could use like a 10-year-old CPU and they work totally fine. The secret? Why? Well, guess what? So in a mining rig, the CPU is more like a traffic light. All it does is direct traffic and information coming out of the PCI lanes of the GPU. That's all it really does. It gets more technical than that and does a whole bunch of other things, but in reality, the CPU really doesn't do much. A Core i3 9100 is probably an overkill for this rig. You really don't need it. You could probably gone with like a dual core 5400G or something similar to that. The CPU on this rig is also air cooled with a stock cooler. Another major component is the motherboard, MSI H310 A Pro ATX style motherboard. The reason why I went with that motherboard is it has 7 PCIe slots in it, one full 16X and 6 1X slots. That allows me to put 7 GPUs in it. Why did I only pick that many? Well, this is what we call a residential miner. I wanted higher power density. If I'm using powerful cards, I'm not going to put 7, 3090s in here. I wouldn't be able to run it off this one 1600 watt power supply. And that's a good segue into our power supply. EVGA T2 1600 watt titanium rated power supply. The reason why I went with such a high rating power supply is I wanted the best efficiency possible. So power supplies tend to be most efficient when they're loaded 50 to 75% of their rated capacity. This machine here pulls anywhere between 1100 to 1200 watts. The reason why I only went with that number is because this is what we call a residential miner. It's going to be in a residential setting, like in a house. In the United States, we have 15 amp 110 volt outlets with a maximum 1500 watt draw. Now, you can do that temporarily for like a spike or starting up, but you generally don't want to load the power 100% full time. You want to do what we call the 80% rule for safety. This is only taking 80% of 15 amps, which is around 12 amps. It does not take more than 1200 watts full time. That's the reason why I went with the EVGA T2 1600 watt power supply. Another part that I get a lot of questions about are the GPUs themselves. What are they? Does that void the warranty? Why did you choose it? Why did you water cool it? Why did I water cool it? I'm not sure. Probably because I wanted to waste my money. I have no idea. These are actually Powercolor Liquid Devil 5700 XTs. As you can see, I got the boxes right here. Yep, that's right. These are 7 Powercolor Liquid Devil 5700 XTs. These GPUs come from Powercolor with the EK water block already pre-applied. You don't have to put it on yourself. It's literally done for you from the factory. If I were to get a different type of GPU, I could always put the water block on myself, as long as it's compatible, and that does not void your warranty, at least with most GPU manufacturers. What actually does void your warranty is if you apply it improperly, or you do something wrong, or you dunk the thing underwater, obvious things. It is harder to honor a warranty with something like that because you got to keep the air cooler, you got to put the air cooler back on when you send it in for warranty. Generally, it's pretty okay as long as you know what you're doing. The way I have things set up in this rig, the GPUs have anywhere between 35 to 48 degrees Celsius range of operation and temperature. Why the big range? Well, it really depends on the ambient temperature. If the ambient temperature is right around 60 degrees Fahrenheit or 70 degrees Fahrenheit, GPUs run at around 45 degrees, which is pretty good. This thing's been running at 100% the whole time. You can hear it. You can hear how loud my voice is. I'm talking kind of loudly right now, but you can clearly hear the rig. It's not that loud. You can still hear it, yes, it's not dead silent, but yeah, it's pretty quiet. Now we're gonna talk about the liquid cooling system. The liquid cooling system comprises of Koolance quick disconnect fittings are up here. These quick disconnect fittings are double shutoff fittings, which means when you disconnect them, flow stops on both ends. So they're double shutoff dry break fittings. You don't have to drain the entire rig in order to remove one GPU. Say one of the GPUs has a problem. You can simply power down the rig, disconnect the GPU, turn the rig rig back on, have it continue to mine while you try to troubleshoot the problem with that one GPU. This is an EK distribution block right here. All it really is Delrin block with a bunch of G1 quarter threads machined into it. I'm using dual EK D5 pumps, which are water lubricated. They're pretty quiet and they're very reliable. I mean, I think the mean time between failures is like 1500 hours or something. It's quite a bit. They're pretty good. The radiator is a 480 millimeter alpha cool full copper radiator in the back, 480 millimeters by 30 millimeters thick, and that is being cooled off by four Noctua 120 millimeter fans. I have one more radiator on the bottom here, alpha cool 280 millimeter 45 millimeters thick radiator, full copper of course, and there's two Noctua 140 millimeter fans on the bottom blowing up. The air blows this way across the 480 millimeter radiator, going through the GPUs and exhausting this way. We got exhaust going this way and exhaust going this way. As for the tubing, this is 7/8 by half inch diameter tubing. All the PCIe cables are cable mod and they're custom lengths. So each cable is custom length for every GPU going right to the power supply. There's no slack, everything is in perfect length. Now the part that everyone asks me about. How much did it cost? How much money does it make? Why did you water cool it? I did this for fun. This was a passion project. I took ROI, return on investment, put in a little box and tossed it out the window. Obviously, if I wanted the lowest ROI time, I wouldn't have done it this way. I wanted high hash rate. I wanted to be quiet. I also wanted to be cool. And this achieves all every one of those things. Now, is it worth the premium? Well, that depends. A lot of people ask how much this rig costs. Prices change on everything all the time. Especially at the time of filming, we have human malware going on right now that's causing computer hardware prices to go through the roof. I have attached in the description below the PC part picker list with every single part that was used on this rig. There's over 100 individual components, so I'm not gonna go over every single one. GPUs themselves, they're all the same GPU. You can use that list and calculate the total price, how much it would cost for your situation. Another question I get is, how much does this rig make? How much crypto are you getting? Well, that's another one of those things that changes literally from day to day. You can actually calculate that number yourself. Between 380 mega hash and 400 mega hash. Take that number and use your own electrical rate. Go use any Ethereum mining calculator, type those numbers in, and then you can see for yourself what kind of earnings you'll be getting with this rig. If you have any further questions about this rig or kind of how I built it, if you have questions about mining, questions about water cooling, feel free to leave a comment down in the comments below and I'll try to answer you as soon as I can. You can contact me on Discord. You could join our Discord server. Right now it's called Mining Misfits. I'm actually in the server with Chump Change. He's the one in charge of the server. I happen to be a part of the server. I'm a mod on that server. So if you want to talk to me directly, that's the best way to talk to me or contact me. If you have any questions, you can ask me there directly. And I respond pretty quick, at least in that server. If you like what you see here, don't forget to get subscribed and let us know what you thought about this video. We'll see you in the next video.